So the next point we are going to see, that is the face discriminator, which is also called as Foster-Sillé discriminator. So as compared to balanced lobe detector, this face discriminator, or which is also called as Foster-Sillé discriminator, is different in case only with the load arrangements. But the method applying of the input voltage to the diodes, which is proportional to the frequency deviation, is entirely different. If you compare balanced lobe detector and Foster-Sillé discriminator, the whole circuit diagram is same. The load arrangement is also same, but the arrangement of diode D1 and diode D2 is only different. So let us see what it is. And here in this Foster-Sillé discriminator, the primary and secondary windings both are tuned to the same center frequency FC of the incoming signal. Where in the balanced lobe detector, as we have seen, there are three different tuned frequencies which were adjusted for the primary winding as well as for the secondary winding. That means three tuned frequency signals were being used, that is, which were adjusted to FC, FC plus del F and FC minus del F. But here in Foster-Sillé discriminator, we have going to adjust the primary winding and the secondary winding both to the FC of the incoming signal. This simplifies the tuning process to the great extent and will yield a better linearity than with respect to balanced lobe detector. So let us see the principal operation. So here we can see the circuit diagram of Foster-Sillé discriminator or phase discriminator. Even though the primary winding and the secondary winding both are tuned to the same center frequency FC, the voltages applied to diode D1 and diode D2 are not constant. So this is going to vary depending upon the frequency of the input voltage. So as the input frequency is going to vary continuously with respect to that, input voltage to D1 and input voltage to D2 is always going to vary. Why? Because both the L1 and L2 are simultaneously being tuned to center frequency FC. So this is due to the change in phase shift between the primary and secondary windings depending upon the input frequency. So whatever the input frequency you are going to apply, with respect to that input frequency, phase shift is going to vary. So as the phase shift is going to vary, the primary winding and secondary windings is going to vary, and simultaneously the input which is going to diode D1 and which is going to diode D2 is going to vary. So with respect to that, the output voltage is also going to vary. So let us see the operation of this phase discriminator. The capacitor CP is a coupling capacitor which will pass all the frequencies at the input to the center tap of this secondary transformer. As here you can see, here is a coupling capacitor which is attached to the central transformer of the secondary windings. The C4, here you can see, C4 will bypass the resistance R4, as R4 is always greater to XC4. Therefore, the voltage across this RFC. So we know what is RFC. This RFC is nothing but radio frequency choke, which will be equal to the input voltage V1. So V voltage across RFC is nothing but equal to voltage across V1. So it can be proved that the secondary voltage VAB, so here we can see the output voltage, whatever we are going to take, that is VAB, it gets divided across all the upper and lower half of the secondary windings. So similarly, to get the more knowledge about this, we are going to draw the same diagram again. That means here you can see the same circuitry as that of this diagram is redrawn again over here. That means half VAB voltage is applied to diode D1 and half VAB voltage is applied to diode D2. So the input to each diode is equal to the vector sum of the primary voltage V1 and half of the voltage of half the voltage to diode D1 and half the voltage to diode D2. Why we are going to take the vector sum is that because voltages are not in phase with each other. So V1 plus half voltage D1, V1 plus half voltage VAB is applied to diode D1 and diode D2 because it is the phase are not same with each other. Second, we are going to see is here the phase shift between the primary and secondary voltage is not constant, but it depends upon the input frequencies. The output voltages of the discriminator. The same point included in this discriminator is we are going to see the output voltages of the discriminators. Now, what is the output voltages of the discriminator is nothing but whatever the output you are going to consider for D1 diode and whatever the output you are going to consider for D2 diode is that the voltage V dash we are going to take across D1 and VA dash B dash we are going to take across diode D2. So that V0 is equal to VA dash VA dash, which is nothing but proportional to the individual voltages VA dash 0 minus V dash 0. As the voltage drops are not known, we cannot calculate the output voltage exactly, but it be sure that the output will be proportional to the voltage applied to the input diodes D1 and D2. That is nothing but whatever the output voltage you are going to take across the diode D1 and D2 is the input individual difference between VA0 minus VB0. So these are the output voltages you are going to consider across diode D1, D2 and final output voltage V0. Now let us see, like balanced lobe detector, this phase discriminator is also again divided into three types or three stages, you can say. Fin is equal to FC, Fin is greater than FC, and where Fin is less than FC. So here you can see this is the phasor diagram for Fin is equal to FC. That means where the input voltage is equal to the tuned frequency FC. If these two input frequency voltages are equal, or when the input frequency is equal to the central tap frequency FC, the phase shift between the primary and secondary voltage is exactly 90 degree. So here you can see half VAB is applied to diode D1. So this is the input voltage applied to diode D1. This is the input voltage applied to diode D2. So there is the phase shift between 90 degree. So both the diodes are going to get the similar inputs. So the output, whatever you are going to take across this diode, will be 0. This is the first case where Fin is equal to FC, where net output voltage V0 is equal to 0. Second case we are going to see where for the output voltage where Fin is greater than FC. Now here you can see this phasor diagram. At the input frequencies above the center frequency FC, the secondary voltage VAB leads to the primary voltage V1 by 90 degree. Hence the input voltage to diode D1 is higher as compared to the diode D2. So the output voltage will be more positive with respect to where Fin is always greater than FC. So here you can see the curved portion where it is greater, where VA0 is always greater. That means reduced phase shift. The phase shift has been reduced with respect to that of the primary voltage. So as the reduced phase shift means more positive towards diode D1. And the third case where we are going to see is that Fin is less than FC. In this phasor diagram also you can see where the input voltage to diode D2 is more increased with respect to that of input voltage to D1. That means here the phase shift in the earlier where Fin is greater to FC, this phase shift was reduced, but here the phase shift is, where the phase shift was increased, here the phase shift is reduced. So with respect to that, for input frequencies below the center frequency FC, the secondary voltage VAB, this secondary voltage, that is half the VAB, this secondary voltage of FC leads the primary voltage more than 90 degree. And hence the output voltage of D1 is less than the output voltage of D2, where more negative side this voltage D2 is going to lead in the case where Fvin is greater than Fc. So these are the three cases where we are going to study for the phase discriminator. With respect to that, we are also going to see what are the advantages of phase discriminator. It is more easy to align. That is nothing but this phase discriminator, it is more easy to tune with respect to that of the balanced lobe detector, as there are only two tuned circuit and which both are tuned to the same center frequency Fc. But that in the balanced lobe detector, three different tuned circuits were used, and which is very difficult to tune for three different frequencies. And the advantages of this phase discriminator is that linearity is better as compared to that of balanced lobe detector. But the disadvantage is that it does not provide any amplitude limiting case, similar that of the disadvantage of balanced lobe detector. And here also you can see the characteristics of the discriminator response, where it is also called as S-type characteristics. Again, the same useful range is been given, and this is the output taken across Fc plus del F, Fc minus del F, and the center frequency